As we close out day six, you're looking there at the Universiad Main Stadium here in Gwangju. Today in the highlights, diving competition wraps up. The men are on the platform. We have semifinal women's volleyball action, Brazil taking on Ukraine. We'll go to that very same Universiad Main Stadium for athletics. Hammer throw, women's long jump, both the men and women's 100 meters, and the men's decathlon on the docket here today. At the Nambu University Aquatic Center, still more medals to be won. We'll take a look at women's backstroke among them. And fencing wraps up with two team competition medals taking place here today. The Nambu University Aquatic Center has been the site for diving here at Universiad, but this is the final competition, the men's 10-meter platform final. And there you have the 10 gentlemen that will compete here today. Wang Anki, a back 2.5 somersault with 1.5 twists. He won a gold in the 10-meter platform synchro with Wang Yao, who's also in this competition here today. They were only paired for 1 month before winning that gold medal. But here in the individual, you see a great dive. Not much splash there at all for Wang. He will score 84.80. Now the final dive for Mialin. Arm stand back double. And just unbelievable poise here shown by Mialin to set that handstand and get ready to take off. He is seeking his second medal of the day, having won one already in the mixed team competition. There's a good aerial look at Mialin's dive. An 86.40 for him. That temporarily moves him into first place as the Americans try to grab the camera from us. Now the final dive for Wang Yao. As mentioned, already gold in the 10-meter platform synchro. And a solid dive there for him. Will it be enough to move him past Mialin and to take the gold medal? There's his score, 88.20. And as you see, it moves him into first spot. Wang wins gold. Igor Mialin will take silver. And Wang Anki will win a bronze medal here in the men's 10-meter platform. There you see the Uamju Gymnasium here in Gwangju. This will be the site of Brazil and Ukraine. Semi-final women's volleyball action. We'll look at the third set, 1-1 right now. Brazil serving. And Ukraine, unable to make anything happen, goes back over to Brazil. Bueno da Silva will set up Ana Silva there for the kill. Brazil now up by two. Now Ukraine up by one, 23-22. Alves here cannot get it through the Ukrainian block. That puts us at set point. We get a good look at that solid block by Ukraine. There's Stepaniak, pretty excited about that one. Here on set point. Ukraine gets it to Dubianska, sets it up for Dunik. That one is long. Brazil evens it up at 24. Now Ukraine again. This time Dubianska. She will set up Stepaniak. And that one ends up out off Brazil, 25-24 now in favor of Ukraine. Another set point. Stepaniak initially with the serve. Honorio da Silva is long, and that will give this third set to Ukraine. They're now up 2-1. Move now to the fourth set. 19-all. Quick set there from Brazil. Doesn't work, but they're able to get it over. Stepaniak is able to knock that one off the Brazilian block and out. And Stepaniak again gets a second opportunity on that point, and she puts that one home. And there is that second look she had. And Ukraine inching closer to the gold medal match. 22-21, they lead. Right there, that's a huge kill. That's Katarina Dudnik, now on match point. Brazil trying to stay in this match. Dug up there, and here from the back row, that one long. And that will do it. Ukraine off to the gold medal match, defeating the defending bronze medalist Brazil. They will face either Japan or Russia in the gold medal match.
Sunnier conditions today at athletics here at the Gwangju Universiad main stadium. We dealt with some driving rain last night, but much clearer today. Men's hammer throw, the final. And there you see the competitors. We will first take a look at Pavel Fajdic. This is his sixth and final attempt. He is the two-time defending Universiad champion from both Kazan and Shenzhen. And he also won the world championship in 2013 in Moscow. And a huge throw there for the pole. 80.05 meters. Now move on. This is Pavel Barysha of Belarus. He has a personal best of 77.03 meters he set earlier this year. Solid throw for him too, as his coach looks on. 75.75 there for Barysha. And we'll jump back now to the third attempt. This is Sirai Kalamoyets, also of Belarus. He is currently ranked 31st in the world. Gets a good throw off there. And he will score 74.68 on this throw. That'll be his best of the day and enough to put him in third spot. So it'll be Pavel Fajdic winning his third straight Universiad gold medal in men's hammer. Silver to Barysha, bronze to Kalamoyets. Now the women's long jump final. And there are the athletes, 12 of them. First up, this is Yulia Piluzhnaya. She is of Russia, won a silver at Universiad in Shenzhen in long jump. Nice jump there for her. Her best so far had been 6.64 meters. This one will be 6.79. It's a season best for her. Now Anna Jagajczyk. Michalska, she is of Poland. Silver medal in triple jump at the Universiad in Kazan 2 years ago. Her best so far, 6.54 meters on her first attempt. This is her fourth attempt. She will better that mark, 6.57, also a season best for her. Last up, we'll take a look at Na Anang of Australia. She set a personal best earlier this year back in Australia in Adelaide, 6.33 meters. And she will outpace that one, setting a new personal best, 6.55, enough to put her in third spot and land her a bronze medal. Gold goes to Pidlizhnaya of Russia, and Jacek Michalska of Poland wins silver. Now one of the marquee events of the athletics competition, the women's 100-meter final. In lane 8, from Lithuania, Lena Grinchikaita Samuole. She won gold in Belgrade, bronze in Shenzhen, and silver in Kazan. So she's looking to add to her medal count. And they are off. And you see there in lane 4, Victoria Ziapkina of Kazakhstan pulling away. And she will cross the finish line to win the gold medal. Fourth at last year's Asian Games, she's now added a gold medal from Universiade to her collection. And there you see her powering across the finish line in a time of 11.23 seconds. Shamira Williams of Jamaica finishes second, and Elena Kozlova of Russia third. Now the men's 100-meter final. There is the start list. In lane 6, Ramil Guliev won gold at Universiade back in Belgrade in 2009. Close right now, but pulling away near the end. That's Akani Sambine of South Africa. And for the second straight games, a South African wins the 100-meter medal. Anaso Jobudwana of South Africa won gold in the 100 and the 200 meters back in Kazan, and now Sambine in a Universiade record time of 9.97 seconds, he has won gold. Brown of Jamaica second, and Guliev of Turkey third. Now to the final event of the men's decathlon. There you see the standings after 9 events. Thomas van der Plassen of Belgium leading the way right now, just needs a good solid time here. And as they round the final bend here in the 1500, it is Jeremy Lelivier of France, the Canadian James Turner, battling down here to the finish line. Lelivier trying to hold on to his second overall spot. Turner trying to move up. The other competitors crossing the line. Lelivier exhausted. They're all exhausted. This is 2 days of 10 grueling events. And in the end, it is Thomas van der Plassen of Belgium wins gold. Bastien Ose of France silver. And René Staus of Germany the bronze. Now the men's triple jump. And there's the start list. First up, Dmitry Sorokin. This is his third attempt. He was sixth at the 2015 European Indoor Championships. Good jump for him. His coaching staff loves it. And it'll be a distance of 17.29 meters, a new personal best for Sorokin. Now Hugh Zango of Burkina Faso. He competed at Kazan and finished sixth. He just set a personal best of 16.67 meters on his third attempt. This is fourth attempt. And he betters that again, 16.76 meters now. Now we look at Zhu Xiaolong of China. Set a personal best back in May of 16.93 meters. He likes that one. It'll fall a little bit short of his personal best, but still a good distance, 16.76. And that will be enough to give Zhu the bronze, Zango from Burkina Faso the silver, and Sorokin will win the gold medal here in the men's triple jump. We're back to the pool. Swimming competition continues. The men's 1500 meters here at the Nambu University Aquatic Center. Ayatsugo Harai won the bronze in the 800 meters here already in Guangzhou. Sergei Frolov in lane 3 won gold in the 800 meters. and also bronze in Kazan and Shenzhen. Harai well out in front as he comes to the wall. He will finish in a time of 14 minutes, 56.1 seconds. That is 6.71 seconds ahead of Frolov, who touches second. And Kohei Yamamoto of Japan will finish third, 7.89 seconds back. And there you see the three medalists. Now the men's 100-meter butterfly. Evgeny Koptalov in lane 5 won the gold in the 200-meter event here already at Universiade. While Piero Codia of Italy, he's in lane 4. He won the bronze in the 50 meters here and also in Kazan. You see them powering towards the finish. Koptalov just out ahead of Kodia. Will he hold on? Yes. In a time of 51.50 seconds. Gold medal for Koptalov. His second of the games. Kodia finishes second, and Yawen Sirkin wins his second medal of the games, a bronze. Now one of the sprints, the women's 50-meter backstroke final. Holly Barrett in lane 6 won a bronze in the 50-meter butterfly. And Kylie Mass of Canada in lane 5, she won the gold in the 100-meter backstroke earlier on here in Guangzhou. Good underwater look there as the swimmers power through this quick 50-meter race. Very close as they come up towards the wall. And touching first in lane 6, it is Holly Barrett. And then a bit of an upset, a bit of a surprise. Out in lane 7, Ao of Hong Kong and Yu of Korea, they will take silvers each as they tie here in the women's 50-meter backstroke. For the last time, we'll head to the Kim Dae-jung Convention Center for fencing, the men's team foil. This is the gold medal match between Korea and France. We move on now. This is Kwok taking on Chastanet. Chastanet won the gold medal here in the individual competition, while Kwok won the bronze. Now we're moving on to Kwok Joon-hyuk and Baptiste Morin. And there, a very athletic play by Pouty. That is Maxime Pouty, able to avoid the touch. Very animated, all of these fencing athletes. A great battle there, and a point won by Park. Well, 38-35, and in tight there, another point for Chastanet. And in this one, you can see even the athletes laughing a little bit as they get in close quarters, trying to get that touch. Now, 1 point away from gold. Pouty trying to get it, and he does. France will win the gold medal in the men's team foil. Korea will win silver while Italy takes the bronze. Now the women's team saber competition to round out fencing here at Universiade. Russia taking on Korea. Even the fans are animated, almost as much so as the athletes. 5-all tied now. And again, you see that incredible passion on the face of these athletes and in their voices too. This is Shatilova and Choi. And in that case, both athletes thinking they'd scored. This is a rematch between Kim and Anna Bashta They met in the gold medal bout back in individual competition. And again, there is Choi Soo-yeon urging on her teammates. Korea up 38-31 now. Now we go to 39-34. And another point for the Koreans, only five away now from goal. Final bout between Choi Shin-hui and Evgenia Karbalina. And there you have it. Korea will win another gold medal here in fencing as they defeat Russia 45-37 to sit atop the podium. France will win the bronze medal.